Hallo und willkommen zu Watchmaxes Uhrenvideos. Mein Name ist Axel und ich freue mich, dass du heute reingeklickt hast zu meinem ersten Video des Star Club. Star Club, so werde ich meine Serie nennen, in denen Zuschauer mir ihre Videos zur Verfügung stellen, indem sie ihre Uhren zeigen. Ich werde sie etwas umschneiden, in meinen Kanal integrieren und auf diese Weise eine komplett andere Sicht auf Uhren zeigen, eine andere Meinung, sodass ihr einen möglichst vielfältigen Eindruck bekommt über die deutschen Uhren, die es auf meinem Kanal so gibt. Das ist das erste Video dieser Art. Paul hat mir sein Video zur Verfügung gestellt. Paul, ich finde das super, ganz, ganz toll. Ich danke dir, das Video ist in Englisch, aber ich werde deutsche Einführung dazu sprechen, sodass ich denke, der Inhalt und die Grundaussage wird verständlich sein. Ja, ich bin super gespannt, wie das ankommt. Ich bin super gespannt, wie ihr das findet. Darum schreibt bitte in eure Kommentare, was ihr davon haltet, ob ihr mehr davon sehen möchtet und bestenfalls, ob ihr eventuell sogar mitmachen möchtet. Ja, Paul, stell dich doch einfach mal vor und zeig uns die Uhr, die du uns heute im Video vorstellen möchtest.
Hello, my name is Paul and I'm a fan of Axel's watch channel because I love German watches. And I just thought I'd take the opportunity that Axel has given some of his viewers to present their watches. So this watch is from a brand that Axel has been quite interested in recently called Turbi. And this is my Turbi watch. It's an old military 43. And yeah, I love this watch. It's my favorite watch. So I just thought I would share with you some reasons why I like it. Thank you very much. Okay, so let's take a closer look. Here it is, the Turbi Old Military 43. So as the name implies, it's a 43 diameter case, and it is also available in 40.5 and 45 millimeter cases. Now, when I bought this about 6 months ago, I was considering whether to go for the 40 millimeter, but that would I would have had to wait a few months for that. So I actually ended up trying to take photos and put them up to my wrist on my phone and size the watch at about 40 and 43. And I found actually, I prefer the 43. I think this type of watch is like a kind of like a, suits the bigger size in my opinion. But my wrists are actually quite thin. They're about 6.5 inches. But my hands are quite large. So as you can see, my hands can get away with a bigger watch, especially when I'm wearing a long sleeve shirt. Maybe in the summer with a short sleeve shirt, it would look a little big.
Super. Absolut klasse. Wie ein Profi. Wie sieht die Uhr denn an deinem Arm aus und wie groß ist dein Handgelenk?
I'll put it on my wrist here so you can see. And yeah, it's been a pleasure introducing this watch. It's definitely my favorite watch. Here it is on my 6.5 inch wrist. As I said, my wrist, the lug to lug is 50, which is I can get away with. It looks a little better maybe with a long sleeve shirt, with my kind of small wrists, and it looks great with a jacket. But like I say, I have fairly big hands, so I think I can get away with it. If you had smaller wrists and smaller hands as well, you might want to go with the 40.5 millimeters size.
Ja, die Uhr steht dir ausgesprochen gut, sieht klasse aus bei dir, kann man gar nicht anders sagen. Hast du noch ein paar technische Daten, ein paar Spezifikationen, Anstoßbreite, Horn-zu-Horn-Abstand und solche Geschichten?
The lug width, strap width here is 22 millimeters and the thickness is 10.4. So it's actually quite thin, which is really nice because it has a hand wound movement with no rotor. So yeah, so I went for the brushed case with polished rings. You can see there the rings around the bezel, they're polished. And the back here. So I really like this look. You can choose to have the entire case polished if you want as well. Turbi allows a lot for a lot of different personalization when you order their watches, which is great.
Vielen Dank. Sehr interessant. Gibt es irgendwelche Details, die du uns vielleicht vorab schon einmal mitteilen möchtest zu der Uhr?
I got it on this it's kind of, I guess, a pilot style strap, and it's a really nice strap. I believe it's handmade in Germany, hand stitched, and so this really suits it quite well, I think. I actually tried this on a metal bracelet that I got. That was one of those universal ones with the straight end links, and I don't know, I think it looks much better on leather, this watch, actually. It looked decent as well. I tried it on a NATO strap and it looked pretty good on that too, but definitely my favorite strap so far is this one.
In deinem Video sieht es teilweise so aus, als wäre da überhaupt kein Glas. Kannst du noch irgendwas zu dem Glas sagen, zum Ziffernblatt, zu den Zeigern? Ich glaube, das würde mich und auch andere wirklich interessieren.
So the sapphire glass here is domed, is just, I believe, just domed at the beginning here. Excuse my long nails, I'm a guitar player, so yeah, I finger pick play classical guitar, so my nails are a bit long. It's not, I don't think the whole thing is really domed. It seems fairly flat. It's just the very beginning here. And I actually specially ordered this one with an anti-reflective coating on both sides of the crystal. Ever since I've had my Zin 556A with the double-sided AR, I love that. And they told me that the AR coating they use is not the one with the blue kind of color, the reflection to it. This is a different AR coating. And apparently they said it's not, it doesn't scratch quite as much as the blue coating. I'm not sure how that works, but so far I have no scratches on this, so it's working out well, and it's got that really amazing disappearing crystal look because it's got the double AR. It's a galvanized black surface, and I love the cathedral style hands, the numerals, just the entire presentation of this watch is fantastic. Now, I looked around for this style of watch. Sometimes they're called trench watches. They're basically based on the old military pocket watches with the large numerals like this. It's like early 20th century style. I really love the way Turby did this watch, and I looked at some kind of more expensive versions of this style of watch, and then there is a few cheaper versions, and this one for me, they did it, the presentation is just the best. It's just, it's really really well laid out. It's very symmetrical, and the painting of the numerals is fantastic. It's a very thick application. And yeah, the black galvanized dial, you can see here, I'll just see if you can see that here in the video. And the concentric circles on the small seconds at 6 o'clock are just fantastic. So just a very, very nice presentation of this style of watch. So the other thing to mention here is it's got, I believe, two different colors of loom. The loom on the hands is slightly different than the loom on the numerals. And it's got, you can't really notice in here too much, but if it kind of moved around, you can see these are heat-blued hands, and they're just fantastic.
Du hast die Uhr ja schon länger. Kannst du etwas sagen zum Uhrwerk? Wie genau geht das Werk? Wie findest du das Werk? Wie zieht es sich auf? Was hältst du von dem Werk dieser Uhr?
The precision of this watch is listed as -2 to +8 seconds per day. It says it's shock resistant and anti-magnetic. So you're getting a lot of bang for your buck with this watch for sure. Yeah, it's just, it's fantastic. So the other thing about this watch I love is just how it just kind of glows. It's got a glow to it. Every time I wear it outside and I look at it, it's just brilliant. It's just really, really nice kind of its sheen to it. The hand wound movement is excellent too. It's this movement is I believe it is an ETA Unitas 6498.1 decorated with blued screws, and the winding is just fantastic on this. You can hear it right now when I wind it. Just very satisfying to do that hand winding every day. I really actually look forward to it because it's got this really nice click. to the winding is great.
Oh, das klingt wirklich klasse. Das gefällt mir super gut. Viele Zuschauer möchten immer gerne einen Nightshot sehen, die Leuchtmasse der Uhr. Hast du da vielleicht auch irgendwas vorbereitet?
All right, I thought I'd just show you guys a quick loom shot here. Yeah, this watch has fantastic loom and it's very visible for a long time. Just hit the lights here. You can see it really follows the really brilliant printing they did, painting of the numerals there.
Paul, vielen Dank. Ich bin total begeistert und es hat mir einen unglaublichen Spaß gemacht, das Video mit dir zusammen zu machen. Das letzte Wort soll dir gehören.
That's about it and thank you very much for listening.